box had a little impact there. Bit of a dent here. Got hit a little harder on this side. Generally speaking, these have been well packed from this manufacturer. And again, the only reason I open these up on camera is to show you how well they're packed. And I have about an 80% batting average for opening these up upside down. Instructions, fuel tube, a pole starter. Remove this around the spark plug and the carburetor gently. We're back to having a centrifugal governor on the flywheel. 2-to-1 gearing, like we've seen before. The Hall effect sensor is here, the drive pulley. The magnet for the Hall effect sensor is pressed in from this side. And we have a pulley over here for the rope starter. Still has the improved tank mount. And what's interesting on this, the exhaust and the carburetor are all mounted in one block. This is the intake valve external from the head, and the exhaust valve is down here, again external from the head, and the exhaust valve is operated by this rocker arm that runs off of a cam back here. So when that cam goes around, it moves that rocker up and down. The main benefit of all of this will be that this is extremely easy to take the head off to replace the O-rings on that piston. You take out these 6 head bolts and all of this comes with it. Much easier to work on. This block containing the exhaust valve and the muffler is bolted into the side of the head, and then this block for the intake is bolted onto it, and there's a gasket right here. If we compare this section on the ET1 to what we now have on the ET7, this is much simpler. All of this has been eliminated and replaced by this single rocker arm. On the ET1, if you take these 2 head bolts out and this support for this rocker arm, there's no indexing pin or alignment pins for that, and that thing is free to move. And when you go to put this back on, trying to get this aligned so this hits the top of the exhaust valve and everything is aligned as it should be when you tighten this up, is a little bit tedious. I don't see it as being a big deal, but for someone who has not worked on model engines in that very much, it can be a bit of a problem. This makes life simpler. The ET6 with this flying ball governor and all the linkage and everything on here, this is a very interesting engine, and this engine runs quite well. I like this, but there is a certain frailty about all these small little parts, and that has been eliminated over here. This is fun to look at. It's fairly easy to work on. This comes off and goes back on in alignment quite easily. Again, that's been eliminated over here. This is much simpler. This is a 2-to-1 reduction. So the crankshaft has to go around twice for the cam that's on the back side of this gear to hit the lobe on this lever one time, which would be for the exhaust stroke. The way this works, when the flywheel gets up to speed, these weights travel outward, and that actuates a lever that comes over and holds down on this rocker. And when that's being held down, then the exhaust valve remains open. So the engine won't fire anymore until the weights come back, and now the exhaust valve can close. and that lever runs in this track. A little hard to photograph. And you can see that that goes back and forth. When the weights have traveled outwards, it pulls on this lever. It rotates another lever on the bottom of this shaft, and it holds that exhaust valve rocker down so the exhaust remains open. And then when the engine slows down, this comes back, and that lever comes back this way and releases that arm. The lower end of the conrod's running on a bushing. I put a little oil in there. I put oil on the gears. Anything that pivots, slides, wiggles, or moves, I put oil on it. These do sling oil around a little bit, so I put it on a piece of cardboard. Now, they have reversed the position of this switch. This is off on the ET6. This would be on, so... Very little movement in here. The governor mechanism on this engine controls the speed very nicely, and so far it seems to be pretty easy to start. Some people want to have one of everything. If that's the case, there are four different versions of this hit and miss. Five, actually, if you count the older blue one. If you can't afford to buy all of them, best bang for the buck, in my opinion, is the ET1 or this one, ET7. This is simple. Let's try it again. ET6.